So the second thing that why we are finding these states, these are the states, these states are definite. Both. Yes, this one. Sorry, this one is equation one. Why we want to find the solution of equation one? So, these states are definite energy states. Means they are having a certain energy and that energy remains the same. It is also independent of time. So you remember that what was the equation of Hamiltonian? It was minus h bar square over 2m curly square psi over curly x square plus v. Oh, this psi is not there, and plus v, plus potential. So this potential is also x dependent. And I can write that when this h operates, this Hamiltonian operates on psi, it gives you e psi, which is the Schrödinger time independent equation. So we have this thing that if I find the expectation value of h, now when I write h like this, it means this is the Hamiltonian operator. So this h will be equal to psi conjugate and h and psi and dx. So I know that when h operates on psi, it gives you e psi. So e comes out this one, and this becomes psi mod square. And as the wave function is a normalized wave function, so I will get that this value is equal to e. If I find the square of Hamiltonian, then psi conjugate and square of Hamiltonian on psi dx. Then I can write this, that psi conjugate. When this one operates, I can write this h into h psi dx. Because this is h square again. Now when h psi operates on this, it gives you e psi. Then again h operate on psi, it will give you e psi again. So e once this one and one this one will come out to be e square and psi conjugate and psi dx, which will be equal to e square. So we got what will be the standard variation or the standard deviation in sigma, and this will be equal to the expectation value of h square minus the expectation value of h square minus the expectation value h whole squared divide means square root. Now I know that this one is equal to e square. And what about this one? This is e, so e squared. And this will give you zero. So what does it mean? When the deviation from standard value or the expectation value that you have, when it comes out to be zero, then your states are of definite energy. Like in quantum mechanics, you know, you talk in terms of probability. But for the energy, this will be accurately measured here, because this is equal to zero. This we call definite energy. Like you are having 100 identical samples and you are measuring the energy of that system. Once you measured, it gives you the energy. Let's say it is a hydrogen atom, and the first level energy it gave you 13.6 electron volt minus. The next time you measure on an identical system, it will be again the same. The third, fourth, and so on. Every time you measure, you get minus 13.6 electron volt. Then you say that these states are the definite energy states. Right? There is no statistical data that you want to process. Why you take the average? You take the average because sometime the value comes lower, sometime it comes higher, and so on, and you take the average. How much is the deviation from the average value, from the expectation value? This one gives that. But when this one comes out to be zero, then it means there is only single value, and we call that thing the definite state energy. Clear? So number three is the general solution is a linear combination of separable solution. The general solution, is a linear combination of separable solutions. Now, as we do this, then this will come clear to you that what is meant by the general solution and what is meant by combination, and then combination of separable solution. Let's say that when we solve this equation, the equation one was what? Minus h bar square over 2m and curly square psi over curly x square plus v of psi is equal to e of psi. This was your equation 2, because over here was 1 over psi. With this v was no psi. So if I multiply both sides on psi, then I will get this psi cancelled. It will come here and it will come here. So this is our same equation 2. Now you see that this is a second order differential equation, and second order differential equation is having how many solutions? Two solutions. But here you will come to know that the solutions are more than two. Okay? In one solution, there will be another solution as well. So we say that there may be more solution, like psi of 1 of x is the solution of it, psi 2 of x is the solution of it, and so on. This go on. So for any number of solutions, then they will possess their energies. Like if this is the solution, it will possess energy E1. If this is the solution, it will possess energy E2, and so on. Then we can write that our wave function, the big psi 1 xt will be equal to small psi 1 of x and e to the power minus I e 1 t over h bar. This will be one solution, and psi 2 of xt equals small psi 2 of x e to the power minus e 2 t over h bar will be another solution, and this will also continue. And finally, you will write that the general solution will be psi capital of x t is equal to summation on n, and this n runs from 1 to infinity, sine n of x e to the power minus I e n t over h bar. So when n will be equal to 1, this will be psi 1 e I e 1 t over h bar. When n will be equal to 2, this will be 2, and here will be 2 as well, 3, 4, and so on. This can go to infinity. And there is one thing, that this is the general solution, right? This is the general solution. General solution always does not depend on the geometry. It is a general solution, right? And I will explain you what general solution means. And if we want to make this one specific solution, or a solution with respect to geometry, with respect to boundary conditions, then some constant will come in front of this one. Like, let's say in front of this I am having C1, here I am having C2, C3, and so on. So I can write Cn here. So it will be C1, C2, C3. Okay? And now let's understand what is meant by the general solution and what is meant by the specific solution or solution with respect to the boundaries. Like, you all know that when we go for buying clothes for us, we buy cloth. So every one of us buy around 5 meter. Okay? So 5 meter is a general solution of all of us. There may be something specific. A person who will be around 6-7 feet, then that person will definitely buy more than 5 meter. But overall, the general public is buying 5 meter of cloth. Now, the tailor actually measures your dimensions. Means dimensions means apply boundary conditions, how much is the arm, the leg, and the chest, and all, you can say these measurements, and they design clothes for you, they sieve clothes for you. So now those clothes are actually geometry based, they are specific. Means my clothes may not fit you, but it was the same general solution because they are fitting my geometry. It will not fit your geometry. So the general solution is this one. While when we apply boundary conditions on this one, when we apply the limiting conditions on this one, when we apply our specific geometry on this one, we will get specific solution of this. And that specific solution will be determined by this Cn's. This Cn, this is a function, and this Cn is actually the amplitude of that function. If you mod square all these, like you mod square all these in summation, you sum them as well, then this will always be equal to 1. These you call the coefficients, these you call the amplitude. Whatever name you give to them, their summation on all will give you 1. They cannot exceed 1 if your wave function is this one. Okay? They will not exceed 1 because the maximum value your wave function can have is 1. It is a normalized wave function. So all these coefficients will sum up and they will give you 1. So we will now solve an example, and this thing we will further explain this thing as well, that what are actually Cn's, what are psi n of x. These are actually the orthonormal wave functions, not only orthogonal, not only normalized, but both normalized as well as orthogonal, which we call orthonormal. These are actually the bases of Hilbert space, which we will explain as we go on further. You will come to know about them. As you are having the bases of vector space, you know there are three bases of vector space, which you call the unit vectors. X unit vector, Y unit vector, and Z unit vector. Are those unit vectors orthonormal? Means their magnitudes are equal to 1, which is the mod square actually, and they are perpendicular to each other. X is perpendicular to Y, perpendicular to Z, and so on. So those X, Y, Z in vector, those unit vectors in vector space, the role they play, that role is played by these psi n's. These are actually the bases of Hilbert space. Now it's not a vector space, because vector space is maximum three dimensions, while Hilbert space is, this is associated with a function. So it is having infinite number of bases. You know, when you are having a vector in three-dimensional vector space, and you resolve this into components, you are resolving that vector along the x, y, and z components. These x and y and z are actually your orthonormal bases. Now you are expanding a function. Function is having n number of components, infinite number of components. So your orthonormal basis should also be infinite, on which you will resolve all the components of a function. So this space is a Hilbert space, and we will study this one as we go on in this. But for the first, just keep in mind this one, that this will become C1, Psi1, IE1. This is one solution, and then C2, Psi2, and E2 will be another solution, and so on. And as a whole, their sum is also a solution of this. Individually, they are the solutions, while their linear combination will also be the solution of this. Linear combination means that these signs will not be squared, they will remain linear, and you will add them up. This is a linear combination, because this is a summation of infinite numbers or n number of terms. We call this linear combination of the wave function.